Welcome back for another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies. And in this video, I'm going to kind of peel back the curtain a little bit. I get asked all the time how I make my videos, and I had always intended on making a video to show you how I make my videos, just for those that are interested, and especially with the different course template that I've put together. A lot of the people that are interested in that are interested in how to make good video content for their business, for their online course, just for themselves, for whatever purpose. People want to know how to do this stuff. And just so you know, I've been making videos for probably about 6 years now, and I've tried everything, and I finally have found, and I'm constantly improving, but I've kind of found what kind of works for me. Now, as you notice, I like to do the videos where there's video of me in it. So I'm going to obviously talk about that equipment as well. So first, let me show you the camera that I use. And just so you know, all the stuff that I use, I've tried expensive things, I've tried inexpensive things, and I'm kind of a financially conservative person, so a lot of the stuff that I use doesn't really cost that much. So right here is the camera I use, and it's a high quality webcam, and as you can see, it's very inexpensive. It's only $62. Now, I've actually had this webcam for 3 years. It's not a new model. They actually recently released a new model to this webcam. However, it's not really that much more expensive. So if I was to buy today, I'd probably buy that new model. So this is a Logitech C920. That one's called the C922, but you can get this one. It's $20 less. It's only $61. It shoots video in full HD. And the way I have it set up is I just have it sitting on the top of my monitor that's right in front of me, and that's how I capture my video. Now, there are a few caveats with this webcam. If you're using a PC, there's software so you can control it, but if you're using a Mac like me, you're going to need to purchase this program. It's only like $7, and it's called Webcam Settings, and let me show you that real quick. So here's the settings panel, and it will probably look similar on a PC. There's something you have to disable in order for you to get good video quality. Now, on this channel, if you look at some of my earlier videos, you'll know what I'm talking about with this setting. It's right here. It's called this backlight compensation. This setting right here was screwing a lot of my video quality up, and when I really dug deep and tested different things, that's when I realized that this backlight compensation was screwing everything up for me. So you're going to definitely want to, if you have a Mac, get this app so you can disable it. And if you have a PC, you will probably be able to do that simply with the software that this camera comes with. So that is the camera that I use, and if I was to buy everything all over today, I'd probably buy the same one, or maybe I'd buy the one that's $20 more, the brand new model of this, even though it's more of a gamer-centric type of camera. To get good quality video, you do need lighting. Now, in my room here that I do all my recordings, I have some blinds right over there, and I have them closed. I don't have any light coming in, so I could do my best to kind of control that light. And there's a door right back here that I keep closed as well, so the room by itself is a little on the dark side. Now, what I have is one softbox. Now, I've seen every video on YouTube about lighting, but I tried it all, and I finally found something that works for me, and it's one softbox, and these are softboxes, that is literally just right above me, and it's shooting the light down at an angle like this, and that's all that I have. That's the only lighting I have. I don't have a light here. I don't have here. I don't have one of those three-point lighting solutions with backlights and all that kind of stuff. I keep it simple around here, and I have one softbox. Now, I am looking into, you could look at any of these softboxes. They're not expensive, and mine wasn't expensive. I might have spent $50 on this one light box, and you can see them here. Sorry, they're called softboxes, and so you could pretty much get any one that you really were interested in getting. Now, Right now, LED light panels are very popular, and I am looking into switching to an LED light panel. The only problem is the light that comes off it is so bright that I think it would be kind of hard for me to look at the camera with the light right behind it. So that's the only thing that reason why I haven't upgraded to something different. Now, audio is extremely, extremely important. And this is the mic I have. It's the Blue Yeti. And I probably have it maybe a foot away from my mouth. And it's right sitting here on my desk. And it's the mic that I use. But any condenser microphone is going to be fine. And you want that type of microphone. It's called a condenser microphone. You could use this one. I like this one because it comes with the stand. And I like the little angles that you can have it with right there. And so that's kind of why I like this. This is the exact model I have, but they do have them in different colors. So I think if I was to buy it today, I might buy this black one if I was to buy it today. But this is the one that I have, and I've had this for about 2 years. Now, if you look at any of my videos in the past, I haven't tweaked the audio. In this video, I did tweak the audio, and moving forward, I'm going to start editing my audio a little bit, and I use a free program called Audacity to do that. And at some point in the future, I will make a video on how to improve the audio quality of any microphone, and it doesn't matter which microphone that you have. So that is my audio. Now, here's the thing with audio. You've probably listened to some videos or audio, and you hear all this popping going on, and that's because certain vowels or certain words have parts in it where we push air out of our mouth to make the sound. And so when that, it's called pop filter, because when you make the sound p, air shoots out your mouth, and when it gets into the microphone, it makes that reverberation noise, and it pops, and it doesn't sound good. So you need what's called a pop filter, and this is a real inexpensive pop filter. I have one pretty close to this, although mine has a metal material right here, and this looks like kind of a mesh. This is actually probably better than mine. So any microphone situation, you're going to need something like that to protect the audio. And essentially, when you make a p sound, it basically captures all that air and doesn't let that burst of air shoot into your microphone. So you're definitely going to need that. Now, what I use software-wise is a program that will record everything at the same time. It'll capture my webcam video. It'll capture my audio that comes out of the Blue Yeti. Now, one caveat, I can get audio out of the webcam. It sucks. You definitely want a condenser microphone. So, and then it will record my screen, and it combines all that together for editing. Now, there's two programs that you can do that with. There's Camtasia. What I have been using is ScreenFlow. Now, ScreenFlow is a Mac-only application. You can only get it if you're using a Mac. However, and it's only $99. Camtasia, they just recently released new versions where it's for a Mac or for a PC, and they kind of unified them a little bit. So the interfaces are near identical, and the feature sets are very close. But with that, they also increased the price. So Camtasia is $199. Now, before this video, I had only been using ScreenFlow. This video is actually done in Camtasia, and I'm going to try to do my videos in Camtasia moving forward, because with this new version, there are more features to it that can allow me to have a little bit more polish to my videos, which I definitely want. I'm always wanting to improve my videos. So Camtasia is what I am using for this video, and I'm going to try to use moving forward. So that's pretty much all the equipment that I use. I think it's important, if you want to make quality video content, is to keep it simple. Keep it very simple, and have a system where you know that you'll be easily able to hop in, create your content, easily be able to edit it, and get it up to wherever you want to distribute that content. I think that's the key when it comes to creating any kind of content, but especially video content, is to get the best results with the least amount of effort and the least amount of money. And if I was to list and add up everything that I showed you in this video, you could tell it's not that expensive. I've really spent less than $400 on everything, and I have good quality videos that I release. So anyways, if you like any of the products that I use in this video, I do have links below if you're watching this on YouTube in the video description area, and I'd like to hear what equipment you use. I'm always wanting to improve my video quality, and if there's some suggestions you have for me, I'd love to hear about them. If you can leave that down below, and if there was anything specific that you wanted to learn about my video creation process, you can ask me that question down below, and I'd love to make a follow-up video to this to show you anything that you want to know. My whole process is a complete open book to you. Hey, before you go, I have something for you. And before I get into that, I wanted to ask you to do something for me. If you could give me a thumbs up on this video, and if you're not a subscriber, click on the subscribe button right beneath me. If you have a question on this video, I'd be happy to answer it. You can also leave a comment or a question down below this video. Hey, I put together a course just for you, and I'm gonna give it to you for free. All you have to do is click on the button right here on the right. It's called the 3 Steps to WordPress Success. It's an awesome course. You're gonna love it. I would love for you to join in and enroll as a student in this course. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it, and I do it just for you.